Good morning, dear children. Welcome to the online classes of mathematics of class 5. I am Shashi Mishra. I will be continuing with the mathematics class. So today we'll start with chapter 2, that is four basic operations. So before starting the operations, first we'll see the Bodmas rule. Now what is the Bodmas rule? Bodmas is bracket of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. So according to the Bodmas rule, we have to first, before starting any calculation or any question, we have to start with the bracket. First we will solve the bracket, and that too bracket of division. After that we will solve multiplication. After that addition. And at last we will see subtraction. So here we have taken a simple example. If we take 6 plus 5 minus 2 into 5. So now if we solve this, so according to the Bodmas rule, how are we going to solve it first? First we will see the bracket. So first we will solve the bracket. So how we will write? 6 plus 5 minus 2 is 3, and then into 5. Now second point we will see, after solving the bracket, what comes after that? So before addition, multiplication comes. So here we'll write 6 plus 5 into 3 we will do first. So what is 5 into 3? 15. Now at last we will add. We will take this addition. So what will be the answer now? 21. So now we have taken this and seen Bodmas rule in this. Now if without seeing Bodmas rule, if we solve it in some other way, so let us see how and what will be the answer. Into 5. So now here if we write 6 over here, and if we solve this bracket first, then 3 and 5. Now if we don't see Bodmas rule over here, and straight away we write 6 plus 3. What is 6 plus 3? 6 plus 3 is 9 into 5. So what will be the answer? 9 fives are 45. So now you can see both the answers differ from each other. But which answer is right? This answer is right. Why? Because we have taken the Bodmas rule. So every time we start any operation, we are going to follow this rule and you will have to learn it by heart. Now we will take addition. So the total of two addends is called the sum of the two numbers. Addends are the two numbers which we will take to add and get the sum. So for example, if we take 22 plus 31. So in this, what is the addends? These two numbers, they both are addends. And whatever we will get here will be our sum. So what we will get, this is very simple. You can see 2 ones are 2. 2 plus 3, 1 is 3. And 3 plus 2 is 5. So we get 53 over here. So this is our sum. Now we will see some of the properties of addition. So first property is order property. If the order of the two addends is changed, the sum is not affected. So whenever the order property is, whenever we are taking two addends, means two numbers to be added, if we change their position, place, the sum doesn't change, means the answer doesn't change. Like you see the example I have taken over here, 324 plus 543 is 867. If we add 543 with 324, means if we change the place of both the numbers. Here also if we change the place, if we write 22 plus 31, so what you will get? Still you will get the same sum, you will get 53 only. So order doesn't matter. Here also if we take 543 plus 324, it will also be 867. So now we'll go to the next property. Grouping property. Second property is grouping property. The order in the addends are group does not change the final sum. So now see, this was that even if we change the order, we place right one left side or left one right side, the sum won't change. So here also, if we are taking the sums together, we are grouping them. Two numbers, if we are grouping them, we are putting them in the bracket. Still, if we change their place, the answer or sum won't change. So here we have taken 543 plus 123 plus 234. So answer is 900. So even if we write 543 plus 234 plus 123. If we write like this or according to the first way, still the answer will remain same. How? I will show you. 543, 234. Okay, we are adding it. 4 plus 3, 7. 4 plus 3, again 7. 5 plus 2, 7. Now we will add 1, 2, 3 to it. 10, 10, 9. So what is the answer? 900. Is it clear? Even if we take bracket this side or these two numbers will we take in the bracket, the answer, the sum will remain the same. Now next property is property of zero. The sum of any number and zero is the number itself. Whenever we are taking any number, for example, we have taken 654. Now if we add zero in this, what will be the answer? 654. Why? Because zero itself has no value, and if we are adding something which has no value to the number, what will happen? Number will remain the same. Nothing will be added to the number. Now adding ones. This is our next property. When we add one to a number, it gives the successor of that number. So whenever we are adding one, for example, here we have taken 7777. So if we add one to this, what we will get? We will get 8. 8 is the next number which we are getting, consecutive number after 7. So 8 will be the consecutive, the next consecutive number of 7, and it is greater than 7 also. So what we will get? 777. And what we will call this 8? It is our next consecutive number and we call it successor of that number. So now let us see these questions. We'll solve them. 759864. Now one thing before solving this, which you should keep in mind is, before writing these numbers, we should write them into columns. Like ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, and so on, as you know the table. So now when we write it like this, we know that first we have written the number. Then while taking the second number, we will see that we will start writing that number from the very right side of the question or from the very right side of the previous number. So we'll write 5, 9, 0, 3, and 4. Now we will add it. So what is 4 and 5? If we'll add this 4 and 5, what we will get? 9. If we add 6 and 9, what we will get? 15. So 1 will be carried over here. So what will come now? 8 plus 1 is 9. Here 9 plus 3 is 12. One more carry over here. 5 plus 4 is 9, and 1 plus will be 10. One more carry over here. So whenever we are carrying something over here, 1, 2, whatever, we add it with the original number, whatever lies next to it. So 7 plus 1 is 8. So this is our answer as we have got it over there. So this was the first question. Now let us see the second question. So here we will take 6 nines. After that, plus 3 nines and plus 2 nines. Now something which is little strange in the question is that we are taking a digit. Only one digit is used in whole question. What digit is that? It is digit 9. So when this kind of sum you get, you have two ways to do the sum. One is simply you can add it. Second way I will tell you today how to do it. So let us place this first according to the columns. From right hand side, 3 more and 2 more. Now what you can see over there is 1, 2, 3. We have 3 nines. Okay. So how many times we are going to take these nines? 3 times. So what we will do? 9 into 3. What is 9 into 3? 27. So we will write 7 over here. And 2 will be carried. Again 9 into 3. What will be the answer? 27. 27 plus 2? 29. 2 will again come here. So now here how many numbers are there? 9 numbers how many times? 2 times. So now 9 into 2 will be 18. 18 plus 2? 20. So 2 will come. So here now 2 is the carry and 9 is here. So we'll add 9 to 2, 9, 11, sorry, 9, 10, 11. So this will be 11. So now 9 plus 1 will be 10 and here 9 plus 1 will be 10. So how much we have got? This is the number. So you can see that with this formula, it is so easy to just simply multiply the number and you add the carryovers over there and you get your answer. So after this addition, let us start with the subtraction. So we always subtract smaller number from the greater number. Whereas to check the answer, we add the difference and the smaller number. So now this is the one main quality which we should remember, or rather rule which we should remember before starting with the subtraction. That is, always smaller number we are subtracting from greater number. Greater number cannot be subtracted from the smaller number. And when we want to check the answer, what we do? The difference is the answer which we get after subtracting two numbers. So that difference we are adding to the smaller number. Two numbers we are adding, subtracting. So the smaller number we will take and we will subtract the difference. We'll add the difference to the number and we will get the answer. So let us take the simple example. 74 minus 62. So if we write it like this, so what we will get? 2 here, 1, 12. Okay, so now we want to see whether this 12 is right or not. We want to check it. So how we will check it? This is the difference. Okay, this is the difference which has come after subtracting two numbers. These are the two numbers. And which one is the smaller from these two? This is the smaller. Okay, so what we have written over there? To see the answer, or rather to check the answer, we have to add these two. These two will be added. So let us see. 62 plus 12, how much? 2, 2, 4. 6, 1, 7. So what is the answer? 74. What was the number? 74. This means we have checked our answer. And this is clear from this. Okay. Now properties of subtraction we will see. We'll see first property, that is order property, as we have seen in the addition also. So the order property, the order of numbers involved in subtraction matters. Before we have seen in addition that even if we change the order or the place of two numbers, what used to happen? The answer used to remain the same. But in subtraction, what will happen? The order or the place of a number matters a lot. So here we cannot change the order. So if we take this example, 5,000 minus 4,000. So what will come? Okay, now if we want to minus 5,000 from 4,000, do we get any answer? We will not get any answer. Rather, we will get an answer, but in minus. That will be integers, which you have not studied now and you will study in your higher classes. But according to this property, order property, you have to minus smaller number from the greater number. So, okay, this is it. Now we'll see the next property. So the next property is subtraction of the number itself. If we take two numbers and these both numbers are same, then what will be the answer? Unlike addition, in addition what we will get? If we add two same numbers, we will get the higher number, isn't it, when we add? But if we subtract two numbers, what we will get? 5,000 minus 5,000. We will simply get a big zero. Is it clear? So it is different than addition. This is the property, subtraction of number itself. Now next property is property of zero. Now when we subtract zero from a number, the difference is the number itself. Why? Because zero itself has no value, and if we are not subtracting anything from the number, so naturally the number will remain same. So let us see over here, 5,000 minus 0, number will remain the same. We will get this only the answer, 5,000 will be the answer. Now this property we will see, next property, subtracting 1 from a number. Now if we subtract 1, what will we get? This is an important property which you should remember. So if we subtract a number from a number, we get a... If we subtract 1, so we are taking 4,444. Now if we subtract 1 from here, if you recap what I have told you in addition property, that if we add the number, then what happens? We get the successor of the number. And if we subtract the 1 number from here, we will get the predecessor of the number. That means previous consecutive number. So here we'll get 3. And this number predecessor will be smaller than the original number with which we are subtracting 1. Is it clear? So we'll get 3. So 3 will be the previous predecessor of 4. So our answer will be 4,443. I hope this is clear till now. Now we will take one question to make you understand more clearly. So this is 49876 minus 43095. Now, as I have told you before, mark it, or rather write it in columns. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. Okay. So 6, 7, 8, 9 and 4. 5 numbers we are having. Now next number is 43095. So we will start writing from the very right hand side. So let us write 5, 9, 0, 3 and 4. So let us quickly subtract it. Okay. 6 minus 5 is 1. So here 7 is there, no? 7 is small, 9 is greater. So are we able to subtract 9 from 7? No. We have to take 1 from this side, okay? So whenever we take 1, what will this number will become? It will become 17. Is it clear? So 17 minus 9 will be 8. Here now, because 1 we have taken, then what will happen? Here 7 will be left. Okay, so 7 minus 0 will be, as I have told you before, 0 has no value, so number will remain the same. So all the properties you can see here also, What we have studied, we are applying in the sum also. So here we'll get 7. Now here 9 minus 3 will be 6. And naturally I have told you before that number, if it is subtracted from same number, what happens? It is 0. Okay, so now let us check the answer, whether this answer is right or not. So this is the last part of our session. So let us see. Number is, so here what I told you, these two are the numbers. This is the smaller number. Fine. And this is the difference. This is the difference means answer. So now how are we going to write it? We'll take the difference and we'll take the smaller number and we are going to 0, 9 and 5, and our difference was 6, 7, 8, 1. 6, 7, 8, 1. So now what we have to do? This is the difference. This is the difference. This is the difference and this is the small number from both the numbers which we have subtracted. So now what we are doing? We are adding these two. 5 plus 1 is 6. 9 plus 18 is 17. 1 will be carried. So because we are adding it, we are not subtracting it. Okay, so here also 7 plus 1 will be 8 and 6 plus 3 will be 9 and here 4 will come. Now what is the number? What are you seeing? We have got this number. That means we have proved that we have done this sum properly. So before ending with the session, I would like to suggest you all to continue with the practice of your mathematics. And this is it for today's session. We will meet in the next session with the next part of the chapter. Stay healthy, stay safe, and at home. Thank you.